Drug agents announced today that they have hauled away a record number of pot plants around the state and here on the Central Coast. What's most alarming is pot growers are using public land for their illegal activity. Action News reporter Felix Cortez is live in Salinas with more on what it all means.
Well, Emma, when pot growers use public lands, it threatens the safety of people who use them and visit them, and it endangers the environment that we love. Drug agents are eradicating more and more pot plants every year, and most of those farms are popping up on state parks and federal land. Operations run by ruthless pot growers who show no regard for the environment.
Stripping the land of its natural vegetation, they bring in a large amount of fertilizers, chemicals, a lot of human refuse. They live and bathe and do other things out in the forest.
The growers set up camp to care for and guard their crop. They haul in chemicals that seep into creeks. They lay miles of irrigation line, and they cut down trees and brush to lay down their pot seeds.
This type of damage to those trees, it will take 100 to 200 years for it to grow back.
And the problem is getting worse. This year, nearly 3 million marijuana plants were eradicated around the state. Most of those plants, 2 million of them, were growing on public lands.
It really is about the environmental damage that is being done by people that are forced or at will coming into our country illegally and essentially doing this on our personal public lands that are ours, and they're harming it.
This year, pot was found growing in Big Basin and Castle Rock State Parks. Drug agents say many of the farms are supported by dangerous Mexican drug cartels, and they'll stop at nothing to protect their garden.
This year, we seized a few weapons out in some of the gardens. I know that right over on the other side of the hill, Santa Clara had another shooting this year where they ended up shooting and, I believe, killing one suspect in a garden. So it continues.
For the most part, these pot growers will grow their gardens off the beaten path, so visitors to some of these parks aren't necessarily in danger. But if you stumble across one of these gardens, the best advice is get out immediately and report it to authorities. Aaron?
All right, Felix, thank you. And drug agents say the plants that they eradicated this year alone had a street value of $11.5 billion.